Hi, in this video we're going to talk about a few things that we've learned about making reliable drivetrains. One of the most important things about making a reliable drivetrain is keeping everything simple. And the easiest way to do that with a four-wheel drive system is to have a motor for every single wheel. And that's what we've done right here. And what this really helps with is make sure that there aren't really any mechanical failures in your drivetrain. And it also means that you can easily access the motors and diagnose any problems. Important thing to do in FTC, especially with games that have small game elements such as ResQ, is to make a skirt that goes around your robot that protects your drivetrain against these game elements. And we usually make ours out of polycarbonate because it's a pretty flexible material that can be durable enough against the debris and also be sturdy enough that it deflects it out of the way. In FTC, there's a huge variety of wheels that you're able to use, and picking the right one is very important. So to start off, we have the Tetrix wheel, which is a pretty squishy rubber on the outside, and it's pretty rounded, so you have a center pivot point when you're turning for good reliability, and also has a pretty hard nylon inner core, so it's very durable, and also has a good Tetrix hole pattern to line up, and generally a really good wheel to use. And they also have a 3-inch version, not only as the 4, and so you have a lot of variability. And there's also these wheels from ANDYMARK, and they come in different durometers of rubber. They also have a lined up Tetrix hole pattern. The gray is the hardest, the black is slightly squishier, and then there's blue, which is even more soft. And the main difference there is the softer you have more traction, but it's not as durable, and the harder it's more durable, but not as much traction. And these are really good wheels, very reliable, and you have a lot of variation there too. Then these wheels over here are more specialized. There's Magnum wheels, which we'll talk about later, and they're a type of multi-directional wheel that you need 4 of, and allows you to move in all different directions and very maneuverable while still having pretty good traction. Over here are OMNI wheels, which basically are a wheel that has drive one way and grip, but then can move in another axis as well, so it can basically be used as a swivel or a powered swivel. And these wheels are cool because you can stack them up since they're relatively thin and basically have the same traction as one of these wheels, or similar traction, and have another range of movement. So these ones are from Tetrix. There's a 3-inch version and a 4-inch version. And then there's also these ones from ANDYMARK, which are, these are actually 2 and they're just stacked up right now. But they have a squishier rubber and the rollers are a little bit more square, so depending on what your use case is, these could be more helpful. Another small trick with creating wheelbases that need a lot of power and torque is using, first of all, 3 wheels, but one trick about using this setup and being able to turn well is making sure that this center wheel is further down than all the other ones. And an easy way to do this is using some small washers on the bottom of, say, a motor mount or a bracket, and that really helps create the perfect amount of distance between these 2 wheels so that they're not riding on the mat when you're turning, and this allows you to turn really, really well with a center pivot point. One of the more advanced yet useful drivetrains that a lot of FTC teams use is the Magnum multi-directional drivetrain. And what this is a series of wheels that have angled rollers that allow you to move in all different directions, not only forward and backward and turning. And really what this is a whole bunch of wheels that have diagonal rollers arranged in this X pattern where these 2 are both pointing in and these 2 are both pointing in. And what this creates is a drivetrain that can still move forward and backward and do the normal turns, but it also allows you to move either these wheels both in and these wheels both out, and so you'll move left and right. And that's really, really useful because you're able to maneuver around whatever obstacles you need. By using this advice, you'll be able to make reliable and well-suited drivetrains.